digging $1 million hole for yourself.
Tommy took me off the street, Chip. What's that worth?
You're gonna be on the road till you're 90. You're bored, I can arrange a loan.
No, thanks, Mr. DeCarlo. No. I don't want anybody involved in our future except me and Frankie.
Hey, I just realized something. I don't want to be in this group anymore.
Not now, Nikki.
Don't forget that. I want to go home.
What are you talking about?
I want to go
home. Okay, good idea. To the tour. No. We all take a break.
No. I quit.
You can't quit.
Hey, I got his attention.
Hi, Bob.
Nikki, we're in the middle of a tour.
Yeah, you know, I always hated the tour. Fucking hotels, those tiny little bars of soap. I'm supposed to wash with that soap, you can't even see it.
Nikki, you're talking crazy. Now calm down and we'll figure it out.
I can figure it out. I'm gonna make it real easy for you. I don't want any money. I don't want any side deals. All I want is out.
Nikki, we're in the middle of a goddamn tour. Are you crazy?
Yeah, maybe a little. But I'm not worried. You guys, with all your talent, you'll never even know I'm gone.
We tell them I don't want to be in the group anymore? That's crazy. Well, let me tell you about crazy. After I got married, my wife and I had a few problems, and our kids wound up living with some relatives. I wanted to feel free to screw around, so I arranged it so my kids, my own kids, thought I was their uncle, Uncle Nick. I figured that way they wouldn't feel deprived of a father. Not bad, huh? What I'm saying is none of us are saints. You sell 100 million records, see how you handle it.
$1 million, remember?
Look, there's a lot of guys out there, Frankie. We're gonna find the best two and start paying this Tommy thing off. Bob with me, it'll be okay, maybe. We got a shot. And then he lays it on me.
Listen, you may not want to hear this, but you know,
performing was never really my thing.
You're right.
I don't want to hear this.
You're a single, Frankie. You should be up front.
That group is holding
you back. Look, we got Joel and Charlie. We find two more guys, put you in front. It's Frankie Valli and the Four Seasons. A great drummer, a horn section like we talked about.
And what do you do?
Write and produce.
I don't like it.
Why?
Because you're crapping out on me. I thought we had a handshake.
We do. Look, you want me to stay? I'll stay.
Good.
I want you to stay. Only we'll do better if we make money on both ends and dig ourselves out of the Tommy thing.
What if they don't like me as a single?
What makes you think they like you before?
Fuck you. It's a goddamn roller coaster. I wake up in the middle of the night, I don't know where I am. I think, what the hell happened? What's gonna happen? Everybody leaves. Why does everybody leave? Frankie. This is your time. How do you do that? What? Get me to agree to stuff. It's a gift. I'm not so hot for the road anymore. People keep asking, what happened to the real Four Seasons? We got the Tommy thing hanging over us, so I'm taking everything I can. Every crappy little one-night stand from Medicine Hat, Alberta, to Fly Speck, North Dakota. Nikki was right. Soap keeps getting smaller and the nights keep getting longer, and I'm haunted by this one song Bobby wrote. If I'm the ladder of success, I'm one step higher than the rest. Look at the guts, I passed the test. Believe me, friend, that's all there is. There ain't no more. But if you got a home and family, you got much more than me.
Put that away. Just spent 2 days in the hospital because of that.
Okay, where is she?
You tell me, she's your daughter.
Are we gonna work together on this and turn it into a contest?
You visit when you do
I'm an entertainer, remember things
she
move around.
She doesn't need an entertainer, she needs a father.
Come on, mother, why aren't you pulling yourself together? Hello? Hello?
Can I talk to Mommy?
Francine, where are you, sweetheart? Your mother and I are worried
I'm
sick.
In the city, okay?
Sweetheart, you don't just disappear off the face of the earth for 2 days. You gotta leave a note.
Don't yell at me, Daddy!
I'm not yelling. You got money for a cab? Just get me a cab and come home.
So now you're gonna be my father all of a sudden?
Frankie, it's 2 lousy days, Daddy. You disappear for months at a time.
That's different, Francine.
I know. You're working. You're slaving away on the road so you can give us a good life. I've heard it a billion times. Give me a fucking break! Can I please talk to
Don't
Mom?
Don't talk to me like that, Francine! I'm your pop! Francine?
Good job, Dad.
drugs and a mother. I think it's about the kid. It's all about women. Who's right? Who's wrong? Who's screwed up? I mean, this woman. People turned in. What?
I can't do this.
What do you mean?
I have a small apartment. There's not enough room for your whole family.
Can you stop that for a minute?
Ricky, what's the point? I gotta be out of town for the next week, and I come back and you're on the road. I don't see you for 6 more weeks.
I'm working. It's not a vacation.
And it goes on and nothing changes.
I need these dates. I got a $1 million hole I gotta get out of.
But you dug for yourself.
He was screwing things up. We had to get him out.
So is he out? Don't you get it? You're still working for him. You're sleeping alone in a 2-bit motel in Toledo so he can play golf in Vegas. Is that your plan? Because it's one hell of a stupid plan.
Don't talk about things you don't know about.
He used you. He ridiculed you. He did everything he could to destroy the group, and you take his debt.
He couldn't help himself!
Is that a kind to animals? You know, I thought if you could get out of the neighborhood, maybe we'd have a shot. But you're never gonna get out, are you?
What if we got married?
You and Tommy? I don't think that's legal in Nevada.
You don't give an inch, do you?
I'm never gonna be first in line. I'll always be standing behind Tommy and Bobby and Mickey and Charles. I'm sorry, sweetheart. That's my ride. I've got to go.
Go tomorrow.
And then what? We have a drink and go around one more time? I gotta get off the merry-go-round, Frankie. It's no fun anymore. Stay the night if you like.
You're coming here with some kind of fucking art song. You're never gonna get airplay. Oh, I know all about you and Frankie and the famous handshake. I get it, but
please do me a favor. Release the song.
May I be candid, my friend? Frankie's okay, but he's no Neil Sedaka.
Okay, my friend. First of all, Frankie's never sounded better. Second of all, you take both songs and you don't get either and we're out of here so fast it'll make your ears pop. And most of all, you don't know jack shit about music or talent or cigars.
I don't have a stroke in my office, okay? All right, call me sentimental. Here's the deal. You get the station to play it, I'll release the damn song. They say no. You can take your little work of art and stick it where the sun don't shine.
Thanks, Al. You're a class act.
If you want to get a hit song, it's like the station's in the cross. You gotta get past the record company, the program directors, the DJs, and of course, people.
So Gordio's next stop is this guy Davis, the station's program director.
Bobby, of course. For you, anything. I mean, come on, Marianne, that's a winner. But this other one, the weird one. How come the big push?
I don't know. I want this for Frankie.
Bobby, I'm humbled. That is... What can I say? All my years in this business? I never heard anything so beautiful. Look at me, I'm tearing up. You got it, my friend. 100 plays this weekend, I promise you. On my mother's grave.
We wait. 2 weeks. 3 weeks. Marianne screams up the charts, and a song just lays there. No plays, nothing. Bob's getting crazy, and he just won't let it go.
I was in his office, 100 plays. He swore on his mother's grave.
Bobby, this is the music business. These guys don't have mothers.
Bitch,
face it, kid. They don't want the song.
Well, I want it.
Right, another one.
Not this one. It's a hit.
You want to break this song? Where's Frankie now?
Detroit, the Rooster Tail.
Right, this asshole program director, the one that hates the song.
Yeah.
You get him in there, you lay on the food, the booze, the full treatment. Frankie does the song, the crowd goes wild. The crowd goes wild.
Every night the place comes apart. Because
it's a great song, that's why. And this guy, this asshole, he might be a moron, but he's not stupid. Once he hears the crowd, he'll play the song, don't worry.
Yeah, but that's just Detroit.
Exactly, so you follow up. You do the same thing in Philly, Boston, Chicago, New York. You start a little movement. Word gets out. Stations start getting calls. Where's that song? We want to hear that song. What's wrong with you people? Play the fucking song already! And it'll work, you know what?
Why?
I did Frankie's chart. His moon is in Taurus. The only thing is, I don't think this is going to cost. The label's going to have to cough up.
Forget the label. This one's on me.
Else to come here, the sky that he-
Jersey, you get a string of days that are so thick and humid that you can hardly breathe. Then out of the blue, there's that one morning that's crystal clear and so cool. You thank God for the day you were born. That was my life all of a sudden. A song that almost never saw the light of day sells 3 million copies. And working my way with the group, back on the charts. I'm feeling good. I'm singing good. Between me and Bob, we finally pay off Tommy's debts. We're free and clear. Everything's copacetic. Even my kid Francine, she calls me every Friday night wherever I am and we talk. And it's all getting better with us. When I was a kid and we were going through hard times, my mother would say, "Adoposal anitat." This too shall pass. What I came to realize was it cuts both ways. Bad passes. But also the good. Francine? What? Yes, this is her father. Pay your taxes. You put your trust in a system. You think your kids are safe. What are you supposed to do? Put them on a leash? Chain them to the bed? They grow up. They go out. And some motherfucker with the needle is waiting and it's over.
Thank you.
together, and what better stage for a reunion than this one? We may be just a few hundred miles from where they first started out, but it's taken them four lifetimes to get here to the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome my old friends and brand new Hall of Famers, the original Four Seasons.
This time I plan to get it right.
Hey, fellas, after the show, why don't you come up to our suite? We're having a little party.
We who?
Me and Nikki.
You guys are rooming together.
He brought his own towels. Room 325, family, friends, some food, some music. What do you say?
Definitely.
You guys ever think we'd be standing on the same stage again?
Never thought I'd be standing, period. Listen, fellas, I want to tell you something. This is the greatest award you can get in the world. This is the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame.